owned you forever is gonna be working down there at Walmart. I'm serious. Go to school and get your education. Go to school and get your education. There is no dropping out in this house.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
I don't care what everybody else is doing. I don't care what the world is doing. You guys, this is your time. This is what I'm telling you. The world is going to hell in a wastebasket.
All right.
And it's your time to take charge. Because if you don't take charge, everybody's going. The Lord says, I'm looking for a few good men.
Yes, right. Right.
And women.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
That's going to stand on the truth.
Yes.
And what Jacob, what Caleb and Joshua did was first they listened.
Yeah.
Be obedient and listen to what adults are telling you.
Yes.
Parents, what they have a problem with is that they're doing crazy things and you're saying to the young people, don't do what I do. Wow. Do what I say.
Wow.
It's a messed up state.
Amen.
You need to throw it away.
Amen.
Because young people do 90% of what they see you all do.
Amen.
And only listen to 10%.
Amen.
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 I want you to be obedient and I need you to listen.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I need you to continue to stand on the word of God.
Please.
I need you to walk in truth.
Yes. Yes.
Let me tell you something. God does not need people that are wimpy people.
Right.
No matter how nervous I am standing up here, he needs someone that's going to be bold and speak truth. I didn't come to give you cake and ice cream. I come to speak truth in your life. In this house. Because the young people are dying out there.
Yes.
I have never heard of in my life, you go get grandma, Auntie Sue, Uncle Jack's medicine, put it in a bowl and pick a pill and then drink whatever behind it. Sugar diabetes pills.
Yes.
Glaucoma pills, high blood pressure pills.
Okay.
All of that crazy medicine, and you're living a dangerous moment by putting that pill in your mouth.
Yes.
It is going to kill you.
Yes.
Don't play those dangerous games that these kids are playing. The Kiki, the car's running, you running beside the car. Whoever, Kiki, do you love me? Again, Kiki's going to kill you.
Yes.
There's another thing I've seen. The diesel going down the road, kids are on the side of the road. Before the diesel gets to you, you roll out into the road and let the diesel run up under you. And before the next diesel comes, you roll out and get out of the way.
Whoever heard.
Why are we living dangerous lives? Y'all can live holy and still be happy.
Yes.
Amen.
Can I say that again? Y'all can live
holy
and still be happy. Harder. Not that I love math, but math doesn't Let me tell you why. The reason why we're so separated, even cousins, first cousins, two sisters' children, two brothers' children, don't like each other, can't stand each other, because one is light and one is dark. The white man placed that in our minds to pick us against each other. See, because when we force come force together, because you 10 there, y'all got some sense, right? So y'all gonna hook up with the two, and the 12 of y'all gonna make this thing happen. They decided, because we were a force that could not be reckoned with, they decide to separate the light folks from the dark folks. Support your people and love your people.
That's right. Yes.
Pray for those people.
Right.
Amen. Right on. That's hard. Trust me. Pam been in the way a long time. And my biggest hang up is if you mess over me, because I'm good to you.
Yeah.
So when I'm good to you, I expect you to be good to me.
All right.
And you hurt me.
All right.
Some ugliness come from down here and it rise up in here. Because now that I've got it in my head, I'm going to get you back. But the Lord says, vengeance is mine. I don't went as far as told God, look, Lord, I already got it in my head what I'm going to do. I can do a better job than you. The Lord said, you better hold that thing. You better set that at your side. You better work on that thing. I know you're talking about me on Facebook. You know the best way to respond to somebody's talking about you?
Don't respond.
It takes two to fight. It takes two to argue. It takes two to let that fight.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
I got you, girl.
You got it.
You go down on your knees. You come over here and you put the pillow down in your bedroom.
Great.
Amen.
Watch what the Lord.
Amen.
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 All right,
y'all. People, I
think y'all got it.
Parents. We got it. Y'all didn't think I was going to leave y'all out. First of all, Jesus is the key to raising children.
Amen.
That's first of all. Amen. While we are trying to raise them with the newest cell phone, the baddest outfit, the $100 tennis shoe, the first car when they're 16. I was 37 years old when I paid for my own car. I didn't have my meal. My meal didn't have no money about you. Let me tell you, and if your parents do,
sorry.
God bless you. But that's all right, if they do. But if they don't,
not no $100.
Right.
Amen.
Because if the Lord has blessed you, we don't want you not to show your blessing as long as you ain't going to be arrogant. As long as you don't get beside yourself and forget how you got what you got.
All right, then.
Right again.
Don't hide yourself.
Amen.
Amen. So if you're 16 and you're going to be blessed with a new car, God bless you.
Amen. Put them back.
Jesus is the key to raising children.
Yes.
Fit.
God will give you grace to raise your children.
Amen.
Because we have them in this building and because we have them doing what thus said the Lord, there's somebody else that wants them to do something different.
Yes.
And will teach them to do something different. And will show them how to do something different. So every now and again, they may get off track. They might. Don't forget, when we got off track, and if somebody that loves us and prays on us,
that's right.
We are going to have to snatch our children out of the fire.
Flash water. Right.
The Bible says
Amen.
We've got to find some time to discipline our children.
Yes.
Not just discipline our children. We've got to find family time.
Yes.
Yes.
Family time.
Yeah.
I know somebody said there's no way I'm working 60 hours and you're asking for family time. Mm. Somewhere along the line, the Lord will give you strength.
Yes.
You got to find family time with your children.
Yes.
Yep, we do.
I don't care if it's Wednesday night for 1 hour or Wednesday night for 2 hours. I don't care what day of the week it is, but you need to set yourself aside and find some time for your children.
Amen.
I'm not talking about daycare. I'm not talking about the YMCA. I'm not talking about the community center.
Amen.
I'm talking about parents spending quality time with their children.
Amen.
We give a lot of time to our resources and everything else, but not our children.
Amen.
We've got to love them. We've got to disciple them.
Yes.
We've got to teach them.
Yes.
We cannot get so involved in everything else and not have time for our children.
Yes.
We've got to touch our children. We've got to embrace our children.
Yes.
In Luke 18 and 15, it says, "Come unto me, little children."
Yeah.
And as the children were coming, the disciples was like, "Get them nasty nosed kids away."
Mm-hmm.
Look it up. They were the disciples, mm-hmm. as the children were coming, the disciples was trying to move them away.
Yes.
And Jesus said, "Oh no, bring them to me."
That's right.
This is no better place for you all to be but in the house of the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
He said, "Bring them unto me." And he
that's
touched
right.
them and he wanted to embrace them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we have to do. We have to touch our children. We have to embrace our children.
Amen.
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 If you do not touch your kids, somebody else will.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't affirmate your children, the world will affirm them.
Yeah.
And it will teach them some crazy things.
Right? Mm-hmm.
And some folks make it in, and some folks don't. Jesus spoke to the kids, spoke and said, Jesus blessed them, and he spoke over them. You need to take the time to pray for your children.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
They're coming in,
amen.
And they're going out.
Wow. That's right.
You've got to, you thought that when you left for work, the school was a safe place for your children.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's not anymore.
Right.
It's just not anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You've got to pray and continue to pray.
Yes.
And continue to pray. Right. And continue to pray.
Right.
And continue to pray.
Yes.
For your children.
Yes.
Amen.
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 You better prophesy over their life.
Yes.
You need to tell them that they're more than conquerors.
Yes.
That they're the head and not the tail.
Yes.
That they're great. That
yes.
they're important. They're special.
Yes.
Tell your girls
yep.
that they're beautiful.
Yes.
Yep.
Some of you single mothers, you can't tell your boys anything, your girls anything, because they look too much like their father.
Mm.
Or if I touch
your
home. You don't have to. That child is a part of you.
Amen.
And something about their father, you loved at one time, because that's how they got you.
That's how you got here.
Mm-hmm.
That's how you
so
got
tell
here.
Your moms that they're beautiful.
What?
Tell your sons that they're handsome.
Yes.
Tell them that they're going to be somebody.
Yes.
All of you guys are in high school. Who's in the 9th grade? Who's in the 10th grade? Who's in the 11th? You in the 10th grade? Oh my goodness gracious. Who's in the 12th grade? The twins? OMG! Wow. So I have some seniors, right? So this is what I'm saying to all of you. And I'm not going to ask you this question because I don't want to call you out. But at the center, this young lady was acting out. And I'm going to close. I'm I'm done, y'all. I'm done. I pray something's been said.
Amen.
I pray that I have to be happy to see you, y'all. I pray that when you leave this place, you're better than you were when you came.
Amen. Amen.
But the young lady was acting out at the center. And I said, what grade are you in? And she said, the ninth grade. I said, no, she wasn't mine, right? That was mine. I wanted to snatch her right.
I know that's right.
Okay, I was feeling some kind of way though, y'all, so I had to get together. I said, the ninth grade. I said, so you have 3 more years left of school? And she said, So I said, okay, so what do you plan to do when you graduate? I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
How are you in high school? You don't know the plans that you have for your own life.
All right.
How do you not know? At least have 3 to 5 things. Write them down, young people.
Yes.
Amen. Write them down.
Write them. That's a fact.
One of those things, maybe 2 of those things, you're going to do.
Right.
But if you don't know, how can anybody else know?
Amen.
Listen,
amen.
You're getting to get into that place where it's no longer mama now. It's now you. You're about to be an adult.
Yes.
Right.
You got to make some decisions on your own. They need to be wise decisions.
Right.
So I know some of you may be sitting there and you may not know, but I need you to write them down.
Yes.
Some ideas.
Yes.
Some presidents, some lawyers, some doctors,
amen.
Firefighters, nurses, something, poetry,
right.
Art.
Yeah.
You know, people pay billions of dollars, thousands of dollars for art.
That's right.
And most people that do art, you don't even know that that's a gift of theirs.
Amen.
They keep it to themselves.
Amen.
How you got to plaster it all over the back wall?
Amen.
You guys have to have a plan for your life.
Hello?
This is indeed your time.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Write something down. It'd be better than me.
I pray that the Lord do a mighty thing in all of y'all's lives.
Amen.
Amen.
I pray that you live and not die.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a lot of you think that means literally. You can be walking dead.
Yes.
Like walking on crack.